So we drive 5 hours up the mountain, and we're about to run our snowboards when we realize I forgot my snow pants back at the house. And I'm from Jersey. So there I am, the Jersey kid, snowboarding in his jeans. What's wrong? You okay?
I can't do this anymore.
What do you mean?
Father won't let me date anyone who's not in the Tall and Devilishly Handsome Club.
The what?
It's a society of tall and devilishly handsome men that my father runs. It doesn't get any simpler than that.
But...
I'm sorry. It's over.
Hey, Greg.
Hey, Alex. How you doing? You mean she just left you there?
Yeah, I don't know what to do, Greg. Two serving three. I mean, like, she said I can't be with her unless I was in some stupid club her father runs.
What club?
The Tall and Wickedly Handsome Club or something like that.
You mean the Tall and Devilishly Handsome Club?
Yeah, that's it. I mean, like, I researched it, and there's not even a spot open right now.
It's okay, kiddo. You're probably not missing much anyhow. What did I tell you about the cell phone when we're playing ping pong?
I'm sorry. I'm getting, like, 12 different people telling me to turn on Channel 4 right now.
Good evening, I'm Amy Evans reporting here live from Town Hall with some startling news. Just 4 hours ago, a member of the Tall and Devilishly Handsome Club was found dead in the streets of Trenton. The death of Brian Dawson, age 42, has caused an uproar because for the first time in 8 years, there's an opening in the secret society of the Tall and Devilishly Handsome Club. Current president of the club and father of Jane, Mr. Van Masterson, is here to address the rioting crowds.
Yes, there is a spot open, but only for the most tall and handsome of men. The selection process begins in a week. Good day.
I have to go tell Jane.
Alex, the winds are changing. Nunquam unum confident. Come clad debilitus.
Buzz, what are you doing here?
What are you doing here, Chief?
Alex, what are you doing here?
What do you think I'm doing here, Chief?
What?
Nah, it's just that I was watching the news and I saw that there was a spot open in the club and I was gonna try and get in and maybe we could be together again or something.
Haha, you seriously think you're gonna get into the club? Like, actually?
Well, why not?
Because I already locked in the position. Mr. Van Masterson and I had brunch this morning and I cooked him a delicious omelet. He took one bite of my deliciously tender, crisp, excellent omelet. Practically begged me to date Jane.
Brunch?
Yeah, brunch. You know, the meal after breakfast and before lunch. Ah, sorry, boss. It's time to go.
Eight serving one. What's the matter with you today, Alex?
It's just this jagweed buzz. I mean, he's destined to date Jane against her will. He's definitely gonna get into the club. I mean, he's tall, handsome, has great hair, has an award-winning smile, and he eats brunch. All I have is these snow-stained jeans.
Alex, I have to tell you something.
What is it?
I was once a part of the Tall and Devilishly Handsome Club.
What? You were really in the club once?
It's not as simple as it seems. It never is.
What do you mean?
I was belittled. I was disgraced. I was mortified. I was humiliated. Van Masterson himself threw me out of the club because I was too casual on a casual Friday.
Yeah, that's great. You have to help me get into the club. I love Jane. I can't lose her to that Admiral Omelette.
Come with me, Alex. This is the book, the secret code passed down from generations of Handsome, starting with the original founder, John Wilkes Booth. I stole it from the bigwigs before they kicked me out. Now all their secrets are mine.
And they let you get away with that?
Nah, I pulled the old switcheroo. I switched it with a book of my own.
We really have to wear these things all in November? That's what the book says.
Now this is it, Alex. Once we open the book, there's no turning back.
I'm ready.
Then let us begin. Rule number one, you must be tall.
Well, I'm pretty tall.
Great observation, Alex, but clearly you're not tall enough. You have to want to look tall.
What do you mean?
Straighter, Alex. Height is an illusion. A 3-foot man could be 6 foot if he knew how to truly stand. Stand straight, Alex. Alex, straighter. Straighter. Rule number two, you must have a nice head. Look at yourself in the mirror. See yourself. You've hidden your true head with cheap tricks. Messy hair covering your forehead. Glasses to draw attention away from that weird nose of yours.
I can't see.
Yes, you can. The path to handsomeness has many obstacles. You choose your vision or Jane. Rule number three, you must have style. Alex, you dress like you never touched a woman. Oh, see that guy? He's touched plenty of women.
That's Buzz.
Hey, Chief. What's a loafer like you doing in a nice place like this?
Just getting some new clothes.
Wait, so you're actually trying to be handsome now?
Whatever. Come on, Greg, let's go get some dunch.
You mean Linner, idiot?
I see your handsomeness is only skin deep, my friend.
Shut up, Tubbs. Listen, Chico. You will never get that spot. You will never get Jane. You will never know how to make an omelet like I do. And you will never be handsome.
Well, he is handsome. Straighter! Come on, Alex, you can do it. You're Tarzan. This is for you. Straighter! Come on, Alex. No pain, no gain, no Jane. Straighter! How's it fit?
I don't know, it's kind of snug.
It is time. This is it, Alex. Everything we've been practicing, everything we've been training for, it all comes down to this moment. Here, right now.
I think I'm ready.
Did someone say handsome?
No. No one said handsome.
Oh, well, too bad, because I'm here. Nice to meet you. I'm Buzz.
I just met you 4 days ago.
Get out of here, Buzz.
Wow, Alex, you look so handsome.
Did he say what?
What?
Ha! Let's get out of here, Jane.
Good luck, Alex.
Come on, let's go.
Good evening, gentlemen and Jane, and welcome to the tall and devilishly handsome club headquarters. I am Mr. Van Masterson, current president. Before we begin our tests, I would like to say a few words on handsomeness. The dictionary defines handsome as having an attractive, well-proportioned, and imposing appearance, suggestive of health and strength. Thank you. And now, I would like to introduce a man whose looks are as astonishing as his eggs, Buzz Aldrin.
From the moment I exited my mother's womb, the doctors knew.
Listen to me, Alex. You can do this. I believe in you. I always have.
But
there's one thing I learned when they threw me out of that club. True handsomeness is in here.
Then why'd you spend six
Go
days-
Go forth, my child. Now is the time.
Brothers! May we become one tonight and stand as tall and handsome as the devil until the great Odin lets us stand no more!
Break a leg, Skippy.
And next is Alex Anderson.
Thank you, my, brothers. I'll make this quick so we all don't miss brunch. But really, thank you for attending this fine occasion. I mean, it's not all the time when so many tall and handsome devils like ourselves are gathered in one room. We're all dressed nice, we're in suits, we have our hair done nice, and we're sitting with impeccable posture. I'm sorry, I can't do this. Well, not even a week ago, I thought this was the most despicable club in existence. Never thought I'd associate myself with such a shallow crowd. I mean, what is handsomeness? What is it really? Doesn't beauty lie in the eye of the beholder? But I know what beauty is, because only a few weeks ago, I met Jane Van Masterson. I threw away my pride and dignity and tried joining this stupid club just so I could have a chance to be with her again, because I love her. If that's not handsomeness, I don't know what is. I'm sorry, Jane. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. That's enough. I am here with the results. And the new member of the tall and devilishly handsome club is... Buzz.
Ha! Yes! Look on that, chief! The game is mine and so is Jane! Woo!
Well, I guess this is it.
I'm so sorry, Alex.
No, it's not your fault. Should have focused more on being handsome than wasting everyone's time. I'm sorry, Mr. Van Masterson. You were just...
Haha, no need to apologize, my boy. I came here to thank you.
Thank me?
Tonight, son, even though you insulted my club, you showed me something. That true handsomeness isn't on the outside. It's right here.
Oh, well, you're welcome, Mr. Van Masterson. Goodbye, Jane.
That's not all I wanted to talk to you about, Alexandaria. As much as I once regretted it, I want you to date my daughter.
What? How could this have happened? I'm so much better looking. I'm tall, I got great hair, I got great style, I've got it all, like...
Buzz, you are worthy enough to be in my club. But you are not worthy enough to be in my daughter's life.
What? What about your other daughter?
Not in your dreams, Chief.
Today I've learned what true handsomeness is. In fact, Gregory, I just wanted to say that I am very sorry for kicking you out of the club. I am truly, genuinely sorry.
Let's go get some ice cream.
I need another story, something to get off my chest. My life gets kinda boring, need something that I can confess. Till on my sleeves I stained red, from all the truth that I've said. Come by it honestly, I swear. Thought you saw me wink, no, I've been on the brink. So tell me what you want to hear.